Hey, what's up? I'm still working on the 6-2. Just giving you guys like a little update of what I had to do. I'm going to put some latches on the tailgate. These old trucks had chains that used to hold the tailgate in place. We're going to eliminate all that stuff and put, like I say, some pretty spiffy latches on it that, you know, keep it shut. Here's a piece of one. But you can see the way I had to cut it out, and we're still in the process of installing the actual latch and stuff. But I want to show you guys how I need to cover this indention right here and make it flat. So what I ended up doing was cutting a piece of steel the length of the jam, you know, and then took it over to the vise there and bended it in order to get this side lip. You can see. And then I mark it right here, and now I'm going to go cut it. That way I can get this angle here. And then I'll just trim these edges off, and that should slide right in there. And then I'll just zap it in, you know. And I'm going to cover these holes too and make sure that's all lined up. But that's what we're doing right now on the 16. You see, we still got to varnish the bed, but it came out pretty nice. Got to paint the side of the bed still. Found some more bodywork, some, you know, that it had some damage, and I had to get adjusted. That's why I have the come along on the back, you know, in order to pull it in. You see, got it all painted back here. Now, when we paint the outside here, we just mask it off and shoot all this, and it has a nice clear coat back here and inside the cab. Here's the repair work they had to do when they installed the pop doors. The body work, the welding and stuff I had to get done. All this was worked by that by somebody else. With the metal work was done by somebody else, and I came back and did all the body filler work. And we got that the pop door set up in there. Here. There's the other side. I'll do the body work there, and the other side. I still got to put some more putty and then drill out another hole right here. But there's a couple of low spots I got to take care of. Still getting the jam situated here. Yeah, I had to weld these plates in right here too. That's going to be part of the the latch setup. Then I'll drill a hole here, so it actually latches onto the side of the bed there. But that's something I just put on that side also. You see that little tip right there. All right, there's that little piece that I just made, the one I was just cutting. I went in and cut it a little bit more and grinded it where I wanted it. This is actually going to cover this indention right there and make it flat. So it just took a couple of minutes just to get this in the shape that we want it. I'm going to fit it right there and then weld it in. You can see it looks pretty good. A few tacks in it. You see how it stayed so far. I'm gonna go ahead and grind it down and get it all smooth. At this point, I welded up these holes here where the old chain used to hook. It had a plate in here I went ahead and cut it off. You can see the contraption that we installed. That's it right there. It has a little slides in and out. I gotta go ahead and see where I want it, and then put the hole on this side. That way, when you close it, well, it'll lock automatically. You know, just it'll lock in place. But that's what we were doing when we were cutting all this stuff apart and getting all this the way we want it. I'm gonna have to probably repaint this hole inside the tailgate. You know, it's kind of beat up. It's been just sitting there for a while. You know, since we've been working on everything else. But it's no big deal. Give us a chance to take some of the vents out. And that's what we got to do on this side, too. You see how I welded up all that stuff there. It's ready for bundles. I also found a few cracks. There's one right there. And there's actually a crack in each corner. So I went ahead and zapped those, too, and grinding them down. Go ahead and drill this hole out and see if we can get it lined up where we want it.